Hello, my younglings. Today we're talking about dinosaurs. I got a message from two boys, Peter and Matthias, and they asked me to tell them something about Tyrannosaurus rex. Dinosaurs were huge animals that lived on Earth a long, long time ago, way before you humans appeared. They were as diverse as the animals we have on Earth today, but some were as big as a house, while others were more like a smaller house, forest humor. In fact, some were even smaller than you. Some dinosaurs walked on four legs, while others walked on two. Some ate plants, while others ate other dinosaurs. Although we can't see dinosaurs today, their fossils give us a glimpse of what they were like. Are you ready to learn more? Let's explore the world of dinosaurs. While you humans and your ancestors have lived on Earth for only a few million years, dinosaurs lived for a much longer time, about 164 million years. 164 million? I just found out the other day that it's so long ago. Our galaxy was completely turned the other way, and the stars in the sky were totally different. Yes, our galaxy also spins, making a full circle every 240 million years. Interesting, right? What? Oh, I'll definitely talk about that too. From that very long era of dinosaurs, we'll highlight a few species that ruled the Earth, and among them is the Tyrannosaurus rex. So I'll definitely talk about him. Just hang on a little bit longer. 152 million years ago, during the Jurassic period, among the dinosaur species living on Earth, the Diplodocuses stood out. These dinosaurs were 70 feet long and weighed between 10 and 15 tons, as much as a big truck. Although they were heavy, they weren't the heaviest dinosaurs. The Brachiosaurus weighed around 30 tons, so it was twice as heavy. It is believed that the Diplodocus was the longest known dinosaur. Its neck could reach a length of more than 20 feet, and its long tail had 80 vertebrae. Initially, it was thought that its tail dragged on the ground as it walked, but no drag marks were found alongside the fossilized footprints. Fossils. Ah, a new word. A fossil is the remains of an ancient plant or animal that lived a very, very long time ago. When they died, their remains slowly turned into stone. That's how scientists can figure out what those old animals and plants looked like looking into a time machine through stone. But it's important to know that when you see, for example, a fossilized bone, it's no longer a real bone, but stone that has taken its shape. Let's continue. The Diplodocus had very strong hind legs. Its body was balanced by a long, heavy tail, which was often used as a weapon against attackers. Their size also likely served as a deterrent to predators. It had a very small head compared to its body size and probably a very small brain. Scientists now think it couldn't raise its head much higher than its body, so many earlier drawings of this dinosaur with its head at tree level were probably wrong. Allosaurus was about 30 to 40 feet long and was one of the largest predators on Earth at the time. They were carnivores and ate even the young of Diplodocuses, as they couldn't defeat the adult Diplodocuses, which were much bigger than they. The massive head of an Allosaurus was about 3 feet long and supported by a short, thick neck. Its sharp teeth were curved with serrated edges. Allosaurus had sharp claws on 3 toes of each hind foot. It also had long, grasping claws on 3 toes of each front foot. The long, heavy tail of the Allosaurus helped the animal maintain its balance. Allosaurus was a carnivore that hunted herbivores. When hunting alone, it would hide among dense plants and then leap out at its prey. Some scientists believe Allosaurus also hunted in packs. Together, a pack of Allosauruses could overpower very large dinosaurs, such as the Apatosaurus and Diplodocus. Scientists believe Allosaurus reproduced by laying eggs. This period is also characterized by the development of flowers and insects. Around 130 million years ago, flowers became more vibrant and diverse to attract more insects, pollinators. Insects, such as bees and butterflies, became key pollinators, transferring pollen from one flower to another. This interaction between flowers and insects led to an incredible diversity of plant species, which continues to decorate our planet today. About 110 million years ago, the dinosaur Deinonychus roamed the Earth. Although the juvenile of this dinosaur had a very cute appearance, the adult dinosaurs were very skilled carnivorous predators. They were about 10 feet long, 6 feet tall, and weighed between 100 to 150 pounds. They mostly hunted in packs to successfully take down prey larger than themselves. The name Deinonychus translates to terrible claw, because its strength was in its claws, and it also had excellent vision and hearing. The most noticeable adaptation of this dinosaur to its environment was its feathers. The first simple feather-like structures appeared in them during the Triassic period. They didn't develop feathers for flight, but rather for warmth. Because of the heat provided by their feathers, they could remain active both during the day and at night. Their biggest prey was the Archosaurus, which was mostly herbivorous. Both of these dinosaur species were very fast. The Archosaurus was larger, and it could only be taken down by Deinonychus in groups. With the increasing diversity of dinosaurs, many of them became more social. About 90 million years ago, due to favorable climatic conditions, dinosaurs began to rapidly develop and evolve. Around 76 million years ago, another group of dinosaurs developed, known as the Ornithischians. They were herbivores, like the Diplodocuses, but they developed jaws capable of chewing food. These dinosaurs, Ornithischians, formed the largest herds that had ever walked the Earth. During this period, dinosaurs spread across the entire planet. Just so you know, this is also when the first mammals, your ancestors, began to evolve, and they were like today's mice. About 66 million years ago, dinosaurs were the most dominant species on the planet, more successful than ever before. 43 feet long and weighing about 20,000 pounds, the most famous predator in the history of our planet was, let me hear it now. Yes, the Tyrannosaurus Rex, or for short, T-Rex. They often fought each other for territory. T-Rex had a massive body, with a mouth full of 60 sharp teeth, each about 8 inches long, and the strongest bite of any land animal ever. Wow, its tooth was as tall as me. Its jaws were so powerful that they could crush a car. Besides its strong teeth, the Tyrannosaurus Rex had a brain about twice the size of other dinosaurs, suggesting that it might have been smarter, with better vision and a stronger sense of smell than other dinosaurs. It ruled the areas of present-day North America and Asia about 68 million years ago, during the Cretaceous period. The fossil of Tyrannosaurus Rex was discovered in 1902 by paleontologist Barnum Brown. What, you ask? What is a paleontologist? A paleontologist is a scientist who studies fossils, the remains of plants and animals that lived on Earth a long, long time ago. Paleontologists investigate the bones of dinosaurs and other ancient creatures to learn what they looked like, what they ate, and how they lived. They help us understand the past of our planet and how animals changed over time. Paleontologists often do excavations in the ground, using special tools to carefully uncover fossils and preserve them for research and display in museums. The skeleton that Brown discovered was only partially preserved. He and his team went on to find several more dinosaur skeletons in the western United States in the following years. Henry Fairfield Osborne, then president of the American Museum of Natural History, named the newly discovered dinosaur species Tyrannosaurus Rex in 1905, which translates to King of the Tyrant Lizards. The best preserved fossil of Tyrannosaurus Rex was discovered in the 1980s in South Dakota. This T-Rex fossil, measuring 42 feet long, was named Sue after the fossil hunter who found it. Although a baby Tyrannosaurus Rex would have been about the size of a small turkey, the adults grew far beyond those feathered creatures. Sue's skull weighed around 600 pounds when it was alive, and it likely weighed about 18,100 pounds, about the same as 5 cars. Sue's fossil is displayed at the Field Museum of Natural History in Chicago. Scientists also concluded that the Tyrannosaurus Rex could walk at speeds of 2.5 to 6 miles per hour. It could run up to 10 miles per hour, which is about the running speed of an average person. And what do you think the lifespan of a T-Rex was? What did you say, 60 years? And you say 200 years? Well, T-Rex actually lived a lot shorter. Its average lifespan was around 28 years. How do we know it was exactly 28 years and not more? Well, scientists came to this conclusion by studying the fossil remains of T-Rex. Sometimes, in the bones of animals, annual growth rings accumulate. This is similar to how annual growth rings, or tree rings, form in trees. Tree rings. I'm full of new words today. Tree rings are layers that form each year as the tree grows, and they look like rings. Each ring represents 1 year of growth. If you take a close look at the stump of a cut tree, you'll see those rings. In spring and summer, when the weather is warm and moist, the tree grows quickly and the rings are wider. In autumn and winter, when the weather is cold and less moist, the tree grows slower and the rings are narrower. These rings help us learn how old the tree is and how the growing conditions changed over the years. By counting and studying these rings, we can discover interesting things about past weather conditions. Just like with animals, each year, a new layer forms on their bones. Scientists can count these rings to determine how old the animal was. If the rings are wide, it means the animal grew quickly. If the rings are narrow, it could mean the animal grew slower or was sick. So, by looking at these rings in bones, we can learn a lot about how the animal grew and how long it lived. But only certain bones preserve the complete set of growth rings. Unfortunately, large limb bones, which are best preserved as fossils, are not among them. The growth rings show that T-Rex grew rapidly, reaching full adult size as a teenager, and these animals tended to die young. The oldest analyzed specimen was only 28 years old. The image below shows a thin cross-section of T-Rex's rib with annual growth rings from age 12 to 19. And now, the saddest part of today's episode. Dinosaurs suddenly went extinct 66 million years ago after an asteroid struck Earth. A huge asteroid hit Earth in the area of present-day the Gulf of Mexico. Immediately after the impact, temperatures skyrocketed due to the fires and heat released by the explosion. Many dinosaurs that were closer to the impact site likely perished from the extreme heat. Combined with the fires that spread over vast areas, this further contributed to their mass extinction. Thus, dinosaurs faced extreme changes in temperature, first with intense heat, and then a sudden cooling as smoke blocked the sun, making survival much harder for many species. Still, one species of dinosaur survived this apocalypse. They were the avian dinosaurs. From these dinosaurs, today's birds evolved. Interesting, right? And the tiny ancestors of your mice survived too. And from them, all mammals developed, including the largest animal today, the whale. Today we've learned a lot of interesting and scientific facts. There have been numerous documentary and animated films made about dinosaurs, which you can watch if you're interested in these creatures that once ruled our planet a long time ago. And if you want to keep exploring the amazing world of animals and nature, don't forget to subscribe. Yours truly, Troll Mitros, naturally.